10 lists in 10 weeks. It's Jeremy, 10 and 10.
Not listed, Idaho State and UMass, because they stink.
Shocker.
Number 10, Liberty, Liberty, Liberty. The Flames went 6-6 last year in their first year of independence. Now, Hugh Freeze, the former Ole Miss coach, is the man calling the plays with Stephen Buckshot Calvert, Spencer's favorite quarterback, coming off a 3,000-yard passing season. Add to that back-to-back 1,000-yard receiver Antonio Gandy-Golden, who is not elite, and a 1,000-yard rusher Frankie Hixon. Third worst team BYU will face, but interesting nonetheless.
BYU's got him in Provo. Don't worry about it.
Not worried when we go to Lynchburg either. That's the name of a city. Are we serious? Number 9, South Florida. The Bulls started 7-0 last season. Then they lost the next 6. That's not good. The new OC is Kerwin Bell, who led Valdosta State to the D2 title, putting up 52 points a game last year. Former 5-star recruit quarterback Blake Barnett runs the show after stops at Alabama and Arizona State. 9 starters return on 0, 6 on defense, but they give up the 9th most rushing yards per game in the country.
See, this one is a little bit low to me. I would think the Bulls would be higher on your list, but maybe I'm just really worried about the Eastern time zone trip.
Perhaps. They're on a 6-game losing streak. That's not good. Number 8. San Diego State. The 7-6 Aztecs lost 4 Mountain West games by a total of 17 points. They put up 21 a game. That was 12th worst in FBS. So they have the new same OC in Jeff Horton, but a new spread scheme this fall. Juwan Washington came 1 yard short of 1,000. He averaged 5 yards a carry, had 10 touchdowns. That was despite missing 4 games. That's the lone bright spot coming back. Third round pick tight end Kahale Waring is gone.
San Diego State has a good running back. That's weird.
Yeah, super weird, right? Donnell Pumphrey and what's his bucket? My guy with the Seahawks. Can't remember. Number 7, Toledo. What is it? I can't remember. One of the MAC's most consistent programs equaled BYU's 7-6 record last year, and that was with a conference leading 40 points per game. Gone are the Rockets' top 3 receivers. However, both starting quarterbacks are back. Both running backs return. That defense, however, give up 30 a game, 255 through the air.
This is another weird game. Eastern time zone against a team that can beat BYU. The glass bowl is not to be fooled with.
I would expect that we could have a 2016 shootout again.
Sure.
In that game.
Sure.
Number 6, Utah State. It's hard to know where Utah State would be after an 11-2 season, finished ranked number 22 in the AP poll. They could be anywhere from 4-6 on this list, honestly. Gary Anderson back in Logan. Matt Wells and a lot of his staff at Texas Tech now. Quarterback Jordan Love back. Only 2 returning starters, however, on offense, and none of the offensive coaches, including OC David Yost, from the number 2 scoring offense in the country.
Are the Aggies better than one of the Cougars' Power 5 opponents? That's my first question.
That's the question. I'm not sure because only 2 returning starters, 1 lineman and Jordan Love, and not the same staff and scheme.
All right, let's go top 5.
Number 5, USC. In spite of a 5-7 record, SB Nation's S&P Plus had USC at number 46 last year and has the Trojans at number 29 going into this season. New OC Graham Harrell took over for the departed Cliff Kingsbury, who went into the office and then walked out to Arizona. Both quarterbacks back. Look for this Trojan offense to be better than 26 points per game last year. It's lowest in 11 years. I expect a bounce back.
By the way, are you thinking of Ronnie Hillman from San Diego State?
No.
Okay, we'll keep working on that.
I can look it up.
Number 4.
Tennessee. New OC Jim Chaney from Georgia is expected to make a big difference from a bottom 10 offense in the country to at least out of the doldrums of the SEC on that side of the ball. 8 returning starters, including quarterback Jaron Guarantano. 9 wins the last 2 years, not good. I look for 7 or 8 from this group this year in the tough SEC.
So is it better if Utah State is higher on this list and USC and Tennessee hit like 5, 6, or 7? Would that fare better for BYU?
Like I said, 4 through 6, Utah State could be in there in any of those spots, honestly. 4 through 6 was the hardest to figure out. I did 6 for Utah State because of Utah State. Number 3, Boise State. There aren't many programs more consistently good than the Broncos nationally. 52-15 the last 5 years under Brian Harsin. It's been that long, right, without Chris Peterson. Quarterback Brett Rippon, running back Alexander Mattison are gone, but the Broncos have produced a 1,000-yard rusher in the past 10 years, the current FBS record. Florida State is the opener. I expect Boise State to be good again in spite of the fact that we don't know necessarily how good Chase Cord's going to be and who's going to be that 1,000-yard rusher. It's what they do.
Has Boise State primed to be upset by a team like Utah State this year for the Mountain West Conference Championship.
It looks like this could be a year where that happens, but I just trust the heck out of it's Rashad Penny, by the way.
Okay, now it's the top two, Jerem.
The top two, which will give you number one. Number two, Washington.
Oh!
If it wasn't for 8 NFL draft picks this year, UW would be number one still. 15th in S&P Plus going into the season. 10-4 last year, Pac-12 champs. Quarterback Jake Browning replaced by Georgia transfer and former 5-star local guy Jacob Eason. Chris Peterson develops talent. He replaces quality players every year. I expect Washington to be a contender in the North again.
Which means that number one, Jerem, is who?
Utah. This is the first Utah team expected to be really good in the Pac-12, like maybe win it. It has everything to do with the return of Zach Moss and a new OC in Andy Ludwig, who was the OC in 2008 in the Sugar Bowl when Utah went undefeated and beat Alabama. He's back after being the OC at Vanderbilt. That defense is legit, man. Bradley and I, Lecky Fotu on the line, secondary loaded, Jalen Johnson at corner. Julian Blackman's going to move to safety to replace Marquise Blair. This team's loaded. The bad news, or good news if you're a BYU fan, kicking specialist Mitch Wishnowski and Matt Gay have graduated. They were the best of their position, and those are the top 10 teams BYU will face in 2019.
The Utah Utes, the toughest opponent on BYU's schedule in 2019, according to Jerem Jordan. How do you feel about it? Hashtag BYUSN if you want to chime in.